who started the season slowly but has burst to form late in the season to take his goals tally to 19. And he joined the club from Dundee United 4 years ago. And Hearts are paying the penalty for indiscretions on the field. Walter Kidd, Roddy McDonald, Derek Iris and Alec McDonald are all out through suspension, with the result that they have 3 18-year-olds in their 13-man squad, Stuart Gold, Dave Bowman and Gary Mackay. But they also have up front Willie Pettigrew, one of the most prolific goal scorers in Scotland for 8 or 9 seasons, a scorer of 20 goals since his £80,000 transfer error in the season. And he, like John Burke, came from Dundee United. So in brilliant sunshine and before the biggest league crowd of the season by far, Kilmarnock start the match. A reminder, of course, of the 1965 battle between these two clubs, which decided the first division championship when Kilmarnock won 2-0 at Pinecastle. And I think this is by far the most important league match between the two clubs since that time. First free kick of the match goes to Hearts. And they really have brought a very big support through from Edinburgh with them. Shields with a free kick. Well won there by Armstrong, asserting himself early on, marking Willie Pettigrew. It's McCoy trying to find his way past Stuart Gold and by Keith Robin rather, and that's another free kick. Alan McCulloch on the line at the near post. Willie Pettigrew moving in the box. It's won by Armstrong. And played away there by McGivern. Taking no chances and Hearts building up some early pressure on the Kilmarnock goal. There's Marinello, socks at the ankles right at the start. Gold playing it in. It almost fell for McCoy. And that deflection will give the throw to Hearts. Touched behind by Stuart McLean for the first corner kick of the match. So a very heartening start for the men from Pinecastle. Two matches already this season between the clubs in the league. Kilmarnock won 1-0 in September at Pinecastle, and the second match was a 0-0 draw here at Rugby Park. Shields playing it in, a snap chance of McCoy, then for Pettigrew. And that was Armstrong on the way of that effort from Pettigrew. At long last, Kilmarnock get the ball clear. Shields header putting Hearts in trouble, Burke going for that with McLaren, but in any event, the free kick is given way back near the centre circle for a push on Peter Shields as he headed that ball back. Pushing in the back by Armstrong this time on McCoy, claiming that McCoy was backing into him. The familiar complaint of tall defenders, of course. A very difficult situation for a referee to judge. Trying a long range effort. Well, that seemed to catch Alan McCulloch by surprise. It was just off target, but McCulloch, I'm sure, expected a flighted chipped free kick. Oh, very sad sight again. Some trouble among the crowd on the far side. It's populated mostly by Hearts supporters. We've already seen several spectators removed from the terraces, and I think we may see some more. Armstrong lofting forward, and Moore is all by himself to head that clear. And a spectator now in the field. Well, it's been anything but a happy afternoon so far as spectators are concerned. 25 minutes of the first half gone, and the police, whose attentions have been taken to that trouble spot in the terracing on the far side, taking a long time to come across to remove this invading spectator. And Bowman out very, very quickly to make that tackle, and he's going to earn a booking for it. The Kilmarnock player's most unhappy. Kenny Armstrong in particular. I think the complaint is that the Kilmarnock players have the opinion perhaps that Bowman went over the ball. He certainly showed some studs, but I thought he played the ball, I must say. But the referee are judging that was dangerous play, and result of the booking for Bowman. So wrestling there between Moore and Burke. The decision goes to Kilmarnock. Paul Clark, free kick. Clark underneath that with Gallagher. Burke has got round the back. And it's thumped wide eventually by Alistair Laughlin. Well, that's the best chance of the match so far. A high free kick from Paul Clark. Touched on by Gallagher. Burke it was, he tried to find room to turn on the ball. It was blocked initially. Laughlin had the snap chance. And the Hearts goal survives. Burton finding McCoy, Pettigrew winning through the middle. Just running the ball a bit too long perhaps, there's Burton. Well, he's certainly willing to have a go for a goal from outside the box. Dickens Burton, since returned by McLaren. Good piece of play by Shields. He's found Burton going forward, now Pettigrew. Lethal right foot letting him down on that occasion. A great forward run by Byrne. After Shields showed such good dexterity at the halfway line, forward ball nodded back by Byrne into the path of Pettigrew, trying to take it in the volley and just raising it a little. Ball from goal. Here's Marinello in space. There's a Hamill on the left. Now Pettigrew. Fine goalkeeping by McCoy. Pettigrew going so close to getting the opener. It was all inspired by Marinello. Taking that pass from goal in midfield. Going off on one of those educated ones right through the middle of the field, taking us back a few years in time, then releasing Pettigrew. Pettigrew perhaps allowing the ball to run a yard or two too far before attempting the shot. Given there's a lot of space on the left. Pettigrew getting back, using his shoulder unfairly. Well, that's uncharacteristic too for Willie Pettigrew. So Smith now commanding that penalty area. Two-man wall being waved a little bit to the side as Laughlin lines up the free kick. Paul Clark underneath it, so is Stuart McLaren. Clark is still there. Gallagher trying to tee it up for McGibbon. That's a great effort from Robertson, splendidly saved by Smith. Well, and Robertson met that first time on the drop. A very difficult ball going in at the corner, and there was Smith going across. Very quickly indeed. Pettigrew. Good tackle that by Clark. Bowman towards Pettigrew. He's getting away there from Armstrong, and that'll be a penalty kick perhaps. The referee is giving that outside the box. The Hearts players cannot believe it. Quite a cynical late tackle by Armstrong. He's a very lucky man indeed in my view not to incur more of the wrath of the referee. Well, let's see that one again. Whether at all, Armstrong slipped at the crucial moment, allowing Pettigrew to get beyond him. Now, was that inside or outside the box? Well, the referee's view was it was outside. And that will, I think, be a decision argued against by a lot of Hearts supporters. Hamill swerving it in, but that's no problem at all for Alan McCullough. Pettigrew playing it through, looking for McCoy. Is Bowman. Marinello getting a break of the ball. Here to be impeded. He's got the free kick. There's a hurry to take it too, but the Kilmarnock players relying on that chance. Now, something has happened off the ball, I fear. McCoy went down and the referee is now going to see the linesman. So the outcome of this little discussion could be very important indeed. I certainly saw nothing. The linesman is Mr. Willie Moulds of Hamilton. The referee, Hugh Williamson of Renfrew, has chosen the culprit. Now, if it's Jerry McCoy, that means he'll have to be ordered off. Charlie McDonald now must be wondering if he might well have preempted that by substituting McCoy earlier. But also going off the field is a Kilmarnock player. And it's Keith Robin who's also going off the field. So he must have been involved with McCoy in that off-the-ball incident. I think Cooney looking totally impassive. Often finds McGibbon. Often again, lining up the shot. Well taken there by Smith, and once again, spectator invading the field. Now that is the same man who was on the field in the first half. This is quite incredible. And this time the police will certainly become involved.
Low to clinging. He cuts it in. Lloyd teasing one and Smith, and the goal awarded.